Oh, hello. I didn't see you there.
Good afternoon, YouTube. Welcome to the Truth According to Lily. I'm your host, Lily. And the other day, I made this 25-minute long video about how I thought Trip Tucker deserved better from Enterprise, and I still think that. I actually did an entire Twitter rant. You can go and read the thread if you're so inclined. Basically, the video quickly dissolved into another video about how I talk about Star Trek Enterprise and how much I don't like it, and upon rewatching it, I was like, I'm such a dick. And I've tried filming this video a few times, and each time I just got, like, totally derailed and sidetracked, and I don't even know really what the purpose of this video is going to eventually be until I'm done talking and editing it. But basically, I don't want to keep ragging on Star Trek Enterprise. First of all, it's actually really easy, for me anyway, but just because it's like how some YouTubers only make Onision videos and how much they hate them, and I'm like, okay, Enterprise is not even close to being as bad of anything as Onision is, but also, that's not my area of YouTube at all. Drama channels are a guilty pleasure. We all have them, let's face it. But yeah, I don't want my Star Trek channel to dissolve into Lily Hates Enterprise, because I think I'm more than that, and I want to give better content to you guys than me just hating. What now? What horrible, terrible catastrophe has befallen this teeny tiny little town that means absolutely nothing in the grand scheme of things? What? So yeah, I just want to produce better content than me just hating on an entire show. I want this channel to be a place where anyone who likes Star Trek can watch it and just have a laugh, and we can enjoy the silliness of Star Trek while also totally loving the seriousness and the good storytelling that Star Trek has to offer, which is why I always go back. Like, I know some people are just like, you can't watch TNG or Voyager or DS9 after watching Discovery because the special effects are so much better. I don't watch Star Trek for special effects. I watch Star Trek for storytelling. I've always loved the storytelling aspect of Star Trek over the special effects. Like, if you're only here for special effects, then you're in the wrong fucking neighborhood, okay? Because the special effects have only recently gotten good. Although I would argue that The Wrath of Khan, The Search for Spock, and quite a few of those movies have held up fairly fucking well, in my opinion. And I'm a little biased, I think, when I say that, but I also don't think that they look that bad. Also, part of the styrofoam walls and bad makeup is one of the reasons why we always go back to TOS. That's what makes it so special, that's what makes it so campy and corny sometimes, and that's another reason why I like it, but I go back for storytelling, guys. I don't go back for the Monster of the Week episodes, although those are hilarious sometimes. I go back for storytelling, and I think that's why a lot of people go back to Star Trek, and why they don't mind the fact that it's not this flashy $1 million per episode, it's probably more than that actually, multi-million-dollar episode per episode, tiny little cinematic event, you know. With all of that being said, there are some episodes, I'll say probably 10 to 12 episodes of Star Trek Enterprise that I did actually really like, and I can say that while also being very aware that there were some serious missed opportunities and some inconsistencies with characters that were never followed through and, quite frankly, forgotten. That's no excuse for me being a dick. I'm not gonna say I'm sorry because Star Trek is there to be criticized, but I am going to try and rein myself in a little bit and be like, check myself, and I'm just like, oh, that could be a really easy Enterprise comparison, or that could be a really easy Enterprise joke. It's canon, it is what it is, and I can't do anything about that. So what, I'm just gonna keep bitching about things I can't change? That makes absolutely no sense, and it has no room for growth. I think that's what it is, there's no room for growth with that. It's just me regurgitating the same shit, and that's what that video became. It was 25 minutes of me literally repeating things I had already said in, like, three previous videos. Like, you have any idea how badly, all the time, I want to make another J.J. Abrams rant, and I don't? Because I made one video about J.J. Abrams and his movies and how they're great action movies. They're dressed up to look like Star Trek, but it's not Star Trek. So I'm still deep into DS9. I just finished the episode Necessary Evil, which I thought was going to just be another Quark-centered episode. And it kind of is in a way, but it became about Odo, and I was like, finally. Because so far, one of my biggest criticisms about DS9 Season 2 is that there hasn't been enough episodes about Odo or even Sisko for that matter. Like, I feel like I haven't seen Sisko at all this season. Like, barely, like, anything. I mean, there was the episode where, you know, that squirrely douche face you know, the Trill tried stealing Dax from Jadzia, and I was just like, this fucking guy. Fuck you, Lionel Luthor. But I would really, I'm really hoping for more Cisco episodes, honestly. However, I could be feeling that way only because I just got off of watching Disco, which has a main character, has a single main character that we follow throughout the course of the show, whereas TV shows, Star Trek TV shows like Voyager, Deep Space Nine, Next Generation, it is an ensemble cast. Everyone gets their time to shine. So I actually, I guess in a way I do appreciate that, and but it's just kind of weird going from, you know, contemporary television, which I watch quite a bit, to, you know, DS9. Wow, did I just say that DS9 isn't contemporary? Is it? Is it, it's not? I don't really fucking know. Super weird and random. Because I haven't been really retweeting any of it or reblogging it on my Tumblr because I'm trying to remain very unbiased and very neutral on this topic. I mean, I have my opinions on a Pike spinoff show, but randomly the person who's running this petition followed me on Twitter, and I don't know if they still are or if it was like an automated thing or a bot or they just like saw something that I posted about DS9 in my DS9 tweets and decided to follow me. I really don't know, but that was kind of weird. I was just like, you're the fucking guy, and you probably wouldn't like what I have to say. And again, this is a whole Twitter thread that I did this morning. Like, I woke up and I just had a lot of feelings. Like, I slept on my guilt about Enterprise, and then I woke up this morning feeling better. I just had to sleep on it, so I'm really glad I didn't post anything. So I did my little Star Trek Twitter rants, or not rants, but thoughts. I threw them out into the Twitterverse. And I still think that while it would be good, I'm still very unsure if it would be successful. Because you can have a good show and have it not be successful. I mean, Firefly, I'm still not over that. It's been so long. So you can have a very good show but have it not be successful, and I worry that that's kind of where this would end up going. And I want it to be successful. I'm not trying to be a Debbie Downer or a party pooper or a troll. I'm not trolling anyone who wants a Pike spinoff show. It would be compelling, but only to a certain degree, I think. I had to kind of like remind myself, okay, but it wouldn't just be about Pike. It would also include Spock. So you'd have Ethan Peck returning. You'd have number one. I can't pronounce her last name. Sorry, I don't know how to pronounce Rebecca. Insert her last name here. I don't know how to pronounce it, so I'm just not going to try because I don't want to sound like a fucking idiot. Is it Rojaman? Is it Romaine? I don't really know. Is one a salad? Is one a person? I don't fucking know anymore. And you would have this whole new bridge crew that is relatively unexplored. The only original face from the TOS The Cage episode that we didn't see was Dr. Boyce. And you could also, like, throw him in there. I don't fucking care. I had to remind myself that. Okay, yeah, you have your Pike as the face of the ship, basically, but there's also Spock, there's also number one. Is her name Una? Have we decided that? Is that like a fan thing that they've decided, or is her name actually confirmed that it's Una? Because I kind of didn't want to know. I mean, I did, but I didn't at the same time. I also remember seeing something on Tumblr of like a screenshot of like an original character profile. I don't know if it was fake or if it was real, but her name was actually Lee Chapel, and she was Nurse Chapel's older sister or something like that, and she eventually got engaged and like left. I don't really fucking know, but that's where they were going with her character or something like that. I don't know if that's just like a fan myth or something. Lee Una, I don't really give a fuck what her name is. Like, she's number one. I mean, you have the potential to explore what it's like to live with the burden of foreknowledge, but I think we've kind of seen that in other various, not just Star Trek shows, but other things in science fiction. See how this character would deal with it, and if he ever confided in anyone about it. I really, again, I'm unsure if he's just choosing not to tell anyone about it, what he knows, or if that's just part of the deal of taking a time crystal. I don't know. I think it would be like even worse if it's part of the deal. Like, yeah, you know this, but you can't fucking say anything. So have fucking Spock mind meld with him, and that's how he finds out. That would be, oh my fuck, dude, now that would be intense. He can't physically say to Spock what it is that's bugging him, so Spock has to fucking mind meld and see that. Oh my god. Now that would make for some interesting sexy drama. Did I just say that? Whoa. You don't want to know. But on the flip side of that, any danger you put him in has to be handled the right way. It has to be handled in a way that we would, because here's the thing, Admiral Cornwall already puts doubt into our minds. When they put Pike in the room with a live fucking torpedo, I feared for him. They were able to make me fear for him, even though I already know what's going to happen to him. Even though I know that his future is set in stone, and he even is just like, if this torpedo can't go off in this room while I am in here, it's not a possibility. And she puts doubt into his mind, thereby putting doubt into the viewer's mind as well. How impervious to danger really is he? This is just his future set in stone, but are there different paths to that future? We don't know. We just don't know. So that's also a possibility of something they could do with the show. But it also, I feel like I just worry that eventually viewers would be like, but it doesn't matter because we know what happens to him. Like, anything great that happened, that could happen to him in a spinoff show or a miniseries is fantastic. Woo, great. But it doesn't matter because he still gets fucked up in the end. It's still a tragedy. So you're just going to keep building up this character, making him better, making him great, so that we're just, so it just hurts more. Like, that just sounds really sadistic to do to an audience. It just sounds mean in the end, okay guys? And I know there's been plenty of like heroes that meet terrible ends and were torn by it and stuff like that. But does it really have to happen like that? I feel like Trip Tucker, again, is like kind of a good example of this, where he gets traumatized more than most people on the show Enterprise, next to maybe T'Pol, and he gets mercilessly killed in the end by the writers, and it's just like, wow, you really had to do that to him? And I'm sorry, Pike still ends up on a nightmare planet. Anybody can say that's a mercy, and in a way, it is. It is a mercy in a way, but it's still a planet literally made of nightmares. They can take the most beautiful dream you've ever had and turn it into a fucking nightmare if they're bored. The Talosians are evil. I don't give a fuck if they destroyed themselves. Bitches had it coming. Bitches had it coming. Just fucking say. Talos is a nightmare planet. Even though I know I would tune in and totally watch it, because it's not just the character that is that compelling, Anson Mount himself is that compelling. You know how the only person who could have played Han Solo in Indiana Jones was Harrison Ford. He's the only guy who could have played them. Anson Mount's the only guy who could have literally played Colin Bohannon in Hell on Wheels and Captain Pike, and made me believe that he is both of these two different people. Very different people. But he's still compelling, and thereby the characters are compelling and makes me watch. And I would love to see Ethan Peck get a little bit more comfortable being Spock. Those are enormous ears to fill, guys. Like, fuck them, those are big boots to fill. Like, for fuck's sake, those are ears you have to fill, man. But I would really recommend taking the sideburns up and in just a little bit. Spock didn't always have super long sideburns, that's all I'm saying. And sideburns are already a hard look to pull off. What happened? Because he's a really good looking guy, and that was intense. Definitely torn, I'm trying to remain as neutral as possible, but it's just hard when I fear for it more than anything. I just don't want it to be a failure if it happens. And I guess it's really bad that I'm already thinking in terms of it being a failure. Don't take it personally. I literally doubt everything. I doubt everything. I was made this way. I was not born this way. I was made to doubt. I have my reasons. So yeah, this is my video about how I'm gonna try not to make fun of Star Wars. Fucking ball sacks. So this is my little video about how I'm gonna try not to make fun of Star Trek Enterprise anymore, because quite frankly, it's gotten old for me. There's only so many times I can make fun of These Are the Voyages or Captain Archer being a wholesome nice guy but a shitty leader. And I just did it again. I'm not even trying to be funny. My thoughts about, you know, Star Trek and the community I would like to build and try to cultivate. Because I don't want it to just be, you know, like me being a dick about a part of a franchise that some people really like. Because I really like disco, and, you know, I get annoyed when people don't take the time to try and understand it and just criticize it without watching it. I mean, I guess the upside is that I have watched Enterprise from start to finish, so I think I have a better right to criticize it than anyone who just has seen an episode and thinks it's stupid. I mean, at least take the time to watch the thing that you're criticizing is how I feel. I wouldn't go ahead and criticize anything that's happening in Game of Thrones because I have no right to, because I haven't been watching since like season 4 or 5, so who the fuck am I, kind of a thing. So that's just what I have to say today. I'm gonna delete that video because I don't feel bad deleting it, and I think it should be because it's just me being a bitch. And even though I can be a bitch, I don't want to be a bitch. Also, does this look purple or blue to you? When I bought this sweatshirt, sorry, you're getting hugely sidetracked. When I bought this, I thought it was purple, and now it looks blue to me. What is this color? I'm not trying to start like this new, like, is this dress something? I don't remember what the fuck that meme was. I didn't really give a shit. Or is this name such a Laurel or whatever the fuck the other one was. Is this blue or purple is all I want to know. All I want to know. I think it looks good on me either way. I'm just curious what you think. Are your eyes deceiving you?
Why resist?
Resistance is futile. Futile. The struggle is useless. Right. It is, which is why I can't wait to have my cabin in the woods and live as far away from people as humanly possible. So yeah, if you want to read my Twitter rant, if you want to follow my screenshots of DS9, which are really hilarious, by the way, I will include some around here. I also did one for an episode of TOS, This Side of Paradise, like a few weeks ago, and that was fucking hysterical. Like, even if nobody likes them or reads them, they're funny to me, and that's all that matters. Like, sometimes you just have to make yourself laugh. So yeah, I do a lot of DS9 screenshots. You can follow the hashtag that I made, or I don't even know how do you make a hashtag, or you just do a hashtag? I don't fucking know. You'd think I would, because I'm part of this generation, but I think most of the stuff that this generation does is really stupid. Like, what's the word that's going around right now? Clout?
She's trying to get clout.
It's like, who, what the fuck? Who the fuck is making up this shit? It's fucking stupid, honey. That's what it is. It's not clout, it's just stupid. Any idea how many people are laughing at you right now because of how dumb you sound? Wow. I don't really have a high opinion of most people my age, or younger. Most of the teenagers I encounter and work with on a daily and weekly basis are utterly helpless.
You mean it's not a touch screen?
No, it's not. I know you're not that young. Cabin in the woods with Wi-Fi and running water and electricity, of course, because I'm not an animal. I have to be able to keep up with all of the dumb fucking words that are being thrown out nowadays that are utterly meaningless. This is me being a bitch. Whatever. And you know what? Going back to the whole Pike thing, I hope I'm wrong. If it happens, if it comes to fruition, and it's a total success, I hope it is. I want to be wrong. I want to be proven wrong. The older you get, the less of a fuck you give about being right or wrong about these things. Because in the grand scheme of things, in the big picture sort of way, whether or not they make a Captain Pike spin-off show doesn't affect my life that much, if at all. Actually, it affects it in no way that really matters. Why the fuck it doesn't really matter if I'm right or wrong. I don't really care. And I think that sometimes bugs people when you tell them that you don't care about being right or wrong. They try harder. And you're just kind of like, I don't care though. It doesn't affect me. It doesn't change the course of my life. Will it? Does it? I don't fucking know. I really can't imagine the fact whether or not we get a Captain Pike spin-off show, how it could ever affect my life in a deep, impactful, meaningful way that'll change me as a human being down to my marrow. I don't see that happening, sweetheart. I just don't. And I know people sometimes cling to characters and don't want to let go. I totally understand that. I've been through that myself. Human beings love stories, and we love telling stories. And we love admiring characters that can make us believe in ourselves, or that we can relate to in many ways. I've always been able to relate to Spock. Always been able to relate to Spock from Leonard Nimoy to Zachary Quinto. And even in a way a little bit, you know, of the Ethan Peck variety. I know what it was like to be young and angry for no reason and not understand why and feel like you're having a crisis at a young age. Like, I've totally have gone through that. We all have. But sometimes you just have to let go. Sometimes it's played its part and that's the end. And again, I would love to be proven wrong. So yeah, thank you for watching this video. I wanted to say quick little video, but my videos are never little and they're never quick. That's what she said. Gross jokes. Ellie sitting in her usual spot, staring at me and judging me, as she usually does. It is her job. Thank you for watching. Live long and prosper, and stay tuned and turned on for more. Ugh. Oh, I can't even extend my legs all the way. Oh God, that hurts. Oh God. Oh my. Oh Jesus. Well, this most recent episode of DS9 that I'm on, Necessary Evil, Odo's just being a fucking Columbo. He even does the whole, I just have one more question for you. Columbo was always doing that shit. I loved watching Columbo when I was little with my mom. And my grandma. Actually, I probably watched it more with my grandmother. Oh, Bernice. Anyway. Bye.